Hello, folks, and welcome back to the Vertigo Tea Party and Let's Play The Witcher 3. Today's episode is brought to you by Asger. Thank you very much, Asger, for your continued support on Patreon. I very much appreciate it. So first, we're going to get our monies from the arena. Oh, hey, they're actually fighting in there, too. And the troll's even in there, too, still. Just chilling out. Watching, I guess. That's pretty awesome. Oh, Skellige, you're not all, man. Just mostly. Where's my money? Where's my money?
Greetings. Business is booming for us, I can see.
Better believe it. Every man and his hound wants to fight in the cursed arena.
My cut of the proceeds must have grown sizable.
And how? Here.
75 orins.
It's a pleasure doing business in Skellige.
Come again, eh? Great things are bound to happen here. Mark my words.
I hope they do. Good luck.
One experience point. Totally worth it. 20 crowns! Come on. That wasn't even like, you can even buy a water with that. Okay, you can. But feel like we kind of got ripped on that one.
Friends we show heart, foes we show our axe.
I hear that around Skellige. Common phrase. All right, there's a message board over here. Let's go and read it. We'll probably get another contract, and if it's low level, we will skip it. And there's one quest in particular that I would like to get done in today's video, unless something on the message board really jumps out at us. If we can find the message board, here we go. Wanger's execution. Wanger, known as the Blasphemer, was executed for insulting the Great Mother, Goddess Freya. His obscene tongue was burnt in the temple's hearth fire, and his mouth was given to the vipers. Ow, goddamn. May his fate serve as a warning to those who dare spew filth about our heavenly mother. Freya's a hoe. The dike that protected us from floods was seriously damaged during the storms. All who can work should help repair it. Our longships are due to return in the coming days. Scouts have brought word of the raid's success. Be ready to honor our clan's heroes. I heal aching teeth. If my healing fails, it'll pull them out painlessly and for free. The Circle of Druids asks the brave warriors of Clan Brockfar to suspend fishing for tuna at least until the spawning season ends. To anyone who might know anything, Nils from our village has disappeared. It's been many a day now, and he's still nowhere to be seen. So, if you know what's become of him, don't keep it to yourself. Come see me and let me know, even if the truth's grim and dark. For my sister, Brit, who was his betrothed, she's going out of her mind with worry, crying seas of tear and such. I swear to Heimdall, whoever brings me the news will get an honorable reward. Alright, let's see what level that is. Somebody's gone missing. Or was it just a regular quest? Contract here. Oh, here comes the groom. I thought it was going to be the name. Here comes the groom. Level 19. Okay, that's pretty low. Let's do that. Let's go ahead and knock this one out. Thank you, sir. See? I'm nice to people who show me the respect that I deserve and pay me money a lot. Preferably people who pay me the respect I can live without. Oh, nice. The cow's actually like leaning over the side of the gate to eat the grass. That's pretty nifty, actually. It's the little things, man. It's the little things that really make it feel like you're in the world. But yeah, I feel like I could do this one. Ah, shit, of course. I still got this oil on this damn blade. I need to get in some fights. I'll see if I can't find some stuff to fight on the way over. Step?
See you not from round here. What's brought ye to Speakerog?
Heard you've got a job for a witcher.
Aye. My sister's near drilled a hole in me, got pestering me. I hung a notice, hoping she'd let up. Truth be told, didn't really expect anyone to take an interest.
What's this about?
My sister's betrothed. He's disappeared. Folks say he done a runner. Sis claims she saw a beast carry him off.
Sensing you just don't believe your sister.
They had their ups, they had their downs.
Neil's thoroughbred skirt chaser, and Brit's just not easy to be around. But family's sacred. You willing to look into this?
I'll see what I can do. Want to talk to your sister first off.
Brit and Neil's had their favorite spot, cliffs north of the village. Ever since he went missing, she's been wandering about there.
Thanks. I'll go see her.
All right. Then we need to find some stuff to fight so we can get this oil off. Because as far as I'm aware, you can't... There's no way to get the oil off. Like, I've tried resting, and that doesn't do it. Like, it's on there forever. Well, until you've hit X number of creatures to get the oil off. Which I'd actually prefer it that way, generally. But in this one case, it's actually kind of not overtly useful. I'm gonna guess over here. One, because that's where the arrow points, but two, because I was actually listening, and he said to the cliffs north. These are not really cliffs so much as slightly higher than the water rocks, but eh.
Need to talk to you.
Leave me be.
Did you see Nils die?
I saw a shadow, great wings, like a cloud passing over the sky. Then I heard him scream. Something grabbed him, lifted him up, then flew off towards the caves on the shore. But he was alive, screaming my name.
I'll look into it.
That's a hell of a hoax. He really...
caves Brit mentioned.
He really wanted to get away from you, didn't he? He's like, somehow planning some kind of griffin or wyvern to take his ass. He's like, it's worth it. Alright, well, I'll tell you what, it's kind of far, and I'm going to try to get, like, fight some random creatures along the way to get this oil off, and I'll see you guys once I make it there. Alright, we're back. I was able to find some sirens to beat on until I cleared the oil off my blade.
Stinks of carrion. Necrophages.
I'd say so.
Drowners couldn't possibly lift Nils into the air.
Nor do they fly, actually, Geralt. That's probably kind of a important part of this hypothesis. There's no way they could lift him when they fly away. Also, they can't actually fly. So that seems kind of relevant. Damn it. I definitely don't want to just drop down there into them. Come on, drowners. God damn it. I so fucking hate dodging and still getting hit. The fuck? You wanna keep dodging or you wanna give up? Like that, kind of. Like, it doesn't make sense. Sometimes when you dodge like that... Well, we'll call that dodge. The other one is just a roll. Sometimes when you dodge, you obviously get invulnerability frames. But sometimes you don't. Like, there's been times where I dodged, and I obviously should have taken damage, but I took no damage. But then there's times where you dodge and you take damage. So I don't quite understand the thought process on how that works. They'll love that. Yes, Geralt, you're a genius. That's definitely the one I wanted you to attack, Geralt. Randomly just switch, it's fine. Alright, just fucking die. Patience expired with these shitty-ass drowners. Fucking die. Yep, just die. Yep, just die. Alright. Again, we'll have to kind of hope that the food buff doesn't fuck us. Again, every single goddamn contract we got before, where, like, well, not all of them, but, like, a lot of them were just go kill this thing. Ever since then, I've been trying to do this achievement. It feels like there's, like, oh, kill all this other shit in between. And the achievement is vague enough, so it doesn't, you would,
Siren tracks.
But you can't really tell, like, if it would do it, if it counts or not to kill the little shit in between. Logically, of course, it shouldn't. But, again, there's some bugginess with the achievement anyway, with it either not being worded correctly. Oh, God, come on. Found the invisible line. Come on. The quad. Good thing your buddies just decided to hang back while I murdered you. Come on, dickwad. Come on.
What now, you piece of filth?
Just that. Combat does get pretty repetitive. Like, if you don't use signs and stuff, it does get pretty repetitive. It's basically dodge their attack, swing... Geralt swings in a completely opposite direction. Dodge, hit attack three times. They'll dodge, you dodge, attack three times. You dodge. Attack, attack, attack. Until they dodge. Makes you wish we had more damage. But oh well, this build wasn't built for that. I definitely... Whoa. Picked the wrong time for this achievement. The fuck?
Melusine, the mad and dangerous lady of the depths. Clearly used to be worshipped here.
And maybe it still is. Oh, what do we got over here? Probably treasure. At least they're better damn be. Found shit except some steps. Where's my goodies? Not seeing any goddamn goodies, game. Feel like you're betraying me here. Letter to Ingberga Kells and the Ursine crossbow. Maybe this letter will lead us to other Ursine stuff. Because we keep finding it, the enhanced stuff, but we haven't found any actual letters for it. Dear, my dearest Ingberga. Illegible fragment. Arrived at Fort Chursich on summer's first day. He tarried there a while, draining more than one barrel of mead with the Jarl. Soon both were fast friends. Then one day Jarl Torgrir summoned me and ordered me to sail to Spikarog with him to show him to where the sirens were the thickest. It's no exaggeration, my little mountain goat, to say I've never met a warrior like him in my life. He's lithe as an eel and strong as a bear. When the sirens came at us, I hadn't even time to seize my axe before he'd gutted them all. And his weapon, why, I've never seen anything like it. A crossbow, but so small he wields it with one hand. I know he has a sketch of it in his saddlebags, for I spied it when he was packing up. Once he's asleep, I'll try to sketch a copy to take over to a smith in Anskellig, so he can make others. So we can protect ourselves from the sirens, case they return. A legible fragment. Soon as my dawn breaks, we're off. Sirens are swarming thicker and thicker. My hands are numb from so much sword swinging, my breath's ragged, but thinking of you gives me strength. Aww. Well, looks like you didn't make it. But, you got the sketch copy of a... Oh. Ah, nice. So now we actually do have the quest. Sweet. I'm gonna switch back to what we were on, but... But, yeah, we finally got that quest. We might actually... Oh, shit! I don't know why I'm totally panicked there, but maybe I'll actually do that. I've got this quest and one other quest in particular I want to do that I kind of talked about before. And after that, we might go do that. I want to go back up here and try that jump again. I feel like there might be something of value over there. And again, I don't know why I'm so hung up on getting all this stuff. I don't use the vast majority of it. There we go. This is just where... Yeah, I think this is the other path we took before. Yeah, oh well. Oh well, it was nothing. It was nothing. Hello. Totally worth it. Some nice soggy bread. Delicious. It's been in this cave for God knows how long. Full of drowner pee and poop. It gives the bread a little bit of something something. Gives it a little bit of spice. Put hair on your chest. Let me check that. And they really like putting bread around here.
Strange scale color. Not your everyday siren. Same scales as on the altar. Melusine cult didn't appear out of nowhere. Echidna's been living here a while. Went into hibernation some time ago, but it's awake now. And it's hungry.
Hmm. Another echidna, eh? They teamed up with the drowners here? Or are these explosive barrels? That, of course, we won't use, because... Who does that? Actually, you know what? Okay. Come on over here, boys. You guys gonna... Come over here or not, or... I mean, that thing will gladly zap you if you don't wanna. Here, let me give you something to think about. Come on. No? You just wanna keep getting zapped by it? Oh shit, you're still alive. Not much longer though. Alright, little last guy, where you at? Nope. No. See, so much easier with signs, which is, you know, totally unexpected with a sign build, is it? Wait, can I loot that or is that explosive? That's explosive. Oh yeah. Yeah, I was kinda hoping against hope that it would open a path, but nope. It isn't really a mechanic they use in this game. Nice effect of the water on the glens, if you will. Alright, what do we got? Oh, probably him.
Nils. Gotta be. Some monster dropped him from high up. Brit wasn't lying.
Kinda didn't think she was. Oh, just the big old siren. It's fine. Theoretically. It's even got a name, that's cute. Now, crossbows are supposed to be okay to use. If he starts, I just want to make sure I've got crossbow selected and not. Is what I've heard. You son of a... You want to get on the ground here? Come on, bleed! I'm trying to time the attack to hit. As she's like diving. Damn. It's a little slow. Doesn't really work that well. In fact, it doesn't work at all. It just kind of stops her for a split second. I was hoping like if she was in the middle of her attack swoop, that would keep her on the ground, but or it would ground it, but it does not work. We'll just kind of have to wail on, like duck out of the way, I guess, and then wait on it as it comes by. Oh, there it is.
No, Brit.
I like how he didn't even like identify the body or anything. He's like, yeah, that's Nils. How do you know? Well, you know. Can't target it. Not a big deal here, but a little bit annoying. Little slow there. Very forgiving. God damn it, that was fast. You want to shoot crossbow? Thanks. Yeah, we can't really attack fast enough. He takes so long to shoot the crossbow. I don't think you can time it to, because I want to kind of hit it where she's low, so it staggers, so maybe I can try to hurry up and get in and get a few hits. But why are these always gonna be just a pain in the ass? I just want the damn achievement. Just give it to me. I swear, if I start to get near the end of the game and I still haven't got it, I'm just gonna drop the difficulty to like something easy and do it. Because I feel like I should have gotten it already. From at least one or two, like, I feel like I've done three fights without using anything. And we just kind of gotten fucked. No, yes, shoot it at me. The camera. Well. That was an interesting screen. Of course, it doesn't help that sometimes you click the button, he doesn't actually shoot, he's gotta reload. Ugh. And there's no way to tell, like, what, like, stage of that he's on. Jesus. Alright, is there better bolts we can be using? Something to give it, maybe the dot. Ooh! Try exploding bolts. That should be fun. Roll. Nice! And it makes the arrow stuck in the air. With the bolt. Wait, what? Did it damage me? Seriously? It wasn't that close. Girl, you gonna shoot again? I know you're kinda gun shy. Girl? Hello? Girl? There you go! Holy, oh, damn! It did not like that. Wow. I'm not jumping down there, though. For sure. Here we go, here we go. Gonna let it burn a little bit. There we go. Nice. That worked really well. He did not. It did not like having its head or being set on fire. Oddly enough, most people like being set on fire. He's open its mind to new possibilities. All right, let's go turn in and see if maybe that will actually give us credit. That's a nice little bolt there. I'm gonna switch it back though. I don't want to waste them because you know I'm so good at using these split bolts, 10 silver damage. Silver damage is usually what I want. Sure. 15 effect duration. I wonder when does the tracking bolt come into play? Because, like, I remember that first fight with the Wyvern. We had the case of it, you know, trying to run away and all that. But in this one, I feel like that didn't really we haven't done that since, right? It's always been pretty straightforward, so there's not really been a case where we have to track things down. Can we get back out this way? I think we can. Yeah, we can. But yeah, I don't really recall that becoming a thing. There's not really been any real danger. Maybe that's one of those things, like a mechanic that they never really implemented. Like, I feel like the bartering system's that way, right? I feel like that's honestly a pretty half-assed system. Like, I feel like they didn't... Tech, I left Roach with a good view of the ocean. See, I care about him sometimes. Come on, Roach. But I feel like the bartering system was kind of done in such a way that, like, they were gonna maybe enhance it in some way. Like, maybe if you have higher levels of Axie, it could come into play. But, like, there's no real negotiation, right? Because it's... I've only ever seen you get like a very like an extra like 10 or 15 gold out of it, and it's not affected by anything, so at least not that I've seen. So it seems like it's really just pointless. Again, maybe there might be something, you know, that helps with that. I don't know. I thought the third level Axie sign would actually possibly help with that, but it does not seem to. God damn it. Whoa! Pushed the guy off the side. Yeah, there's another achievement. Oh my god, just get off.
These can't
there's another achievement for like pushing like 10 people off the side of cliffs or something. I was like, man, it's pretty rare that I fight people on the side of cliffs. Maybe the Ard Skellig is going to be the place for that.
Master Witcher?
Found an old echidna in a cave on the shore. Tough beast, but I killed it.
So Brit spoke true? A beast took Nils?
And killed him. Body's in the cave.
I'll have to fetch it. Witcher, would ye mind telling Brit what happened to her betrothed?
Fine. I'll talk to her. It's the least she deserves.
Feel like a damn fool now, not believing me own sis. Take this. Hard work deserves payment.
Farewell.
Yeah, I definitely feel like if we were going to get the achievement, we would have gotten it by now. Because now that I think about it, somebody else said when they were testing the criteria for it, they said that they had, like, it popped up at right after they killed the second one. So that might not have counted at all, or it just might have been what it counted as the first one. Who knows? Who knows? Those other chances that I tried it, I might have had like oil on my blade or something like that. I like guys hanging out. Fishing in the rain seems pretty relaxing. You're right by the shore though. I want to go a little bit deeper than that, man. I'm not a fisherman though, so.
Need to talk to you.
Leave me be.
I'm going to argue you right off of this thing.
Your betrothed is dead. An echidna captured and killed him.
Nils.
This won't bring him back, I know. But I avenged him. Killed the beast.
Thank you. Knew all along he was true to me. And so I'll vow to be true to him for the rest of my days. Take this gold. It ain't much. But I want you to take it.
Thank you, but I won't accept any coin from you.
Why do you offend me so?
Don't take it the wrong way. There are things even a witcher shouldn't take coin for.
Hey! Almost jumped right off the cliff. Don't jump off the damn cliff. Don't do it. Alright, just go back to crying. That's fine. Besides, he paid me already, right? Didn't he? It doesn't matter. Again, we're up to like 17,000. I've started selling monster parts, like not all of them, but like once I hit like 30 or so monster parts, I'll sell like half. And those are worth a pretty decent amount. So let's go back to the quest that we got a long time ago. Not our oldest quest, but one of our oldest quests. Where'd you go? There we go. Get blacksmith's tools for Undvik. So, if you recall, our old friend, that dwarf that was in town, wanted us, and I still don't quite understand how this is even going to work, but he wanted us to bring him like a forge, like a legendary forge that we could find on Skellige. And we were really low level at the time, because he was in the Bloody Perch, or Baron's Perch, or whatever it was called. So we need to somehow get that to him. Be nice to have another Master Armor available. Heyar! Heyar! Okay, let's see where this is at. Oh, well, it's even called Clan Tordak Forge. Tordak. That'll be easy. Just bring the forge back to him, right? Alright, let's get the blacksmith tools. Well, he said he wants tools, I guess. Because surely they're not wanting me to bring back, like, an anvil and stuff. Locked. Again, that door's so damn rickety, you could easily blow it off the hinges, Geralt. Oh, yeah. This is that place where we fought those dickwad devourer guys who I couldn't get stuck inside that room. Oh, this is like a great place to work. Very positive work atmosphere. People hanging from the roofs, it gives it kind of a festive feel. Like, hey, if you don't work hard, this is what's going to happen to you. I like it. I like good motivational things that really get you going. thinking, hey, I need to work hard because I want to make something out of my life. I don't want to be a loser like my parents said I would be. I want to make videos and put them on the internet. Yep. It's a body, all right. Nope, it's more this way. Okie doke. Can I just blow this off the... Damn. The Witcher's knock didn't work. But yes, I want to grow up and make something of my life. Like, put videos of myself playing video games on the internet with commentary. Holy shit. Ice troll. Light this lantern so I can see a little better. There we go. Alright, we're gonna axe his ass. I don't think it's very handy or useful. It's Quinn. Actually, first. Nope. Super bad dodging on my part. Casted it right as he walloped me. Come on. One thing I did notice about the Ursine armor, by the way, you son of a bitch, is that, oh shit, nope. You need to stay in here. Look how long Yurden lasts! Of course, I say that it drops. But still, you can get what I'm saying. The nice thing about that hits from the Yurden as well is that sometimes it interrupts them. I didn't mean that, dude. I was trying to igni him. Damn it.
Legendary forge. Need to look around for tools.
Now what do we got here? Infused crystal, elemental essence. Don't think there's anything we can do with that. Thank you. I'm well aware. I gotta make sure not to make this on accident. Because there's something else that I needed like five lesser red mutagens for. This one. Adrenaline points are generated more quickly than normal until the first successful enemy attack. Yeah, that one seems more useful. Especially, one thing I did notice with the Ursine armor is that it generates adrenaline faster. So that I could see being quite handy if you built around that. High quality smithing tools and Deathwin.
Blacksmithing tools, but ornamented. Gotta be the ones Joanna mentioned.
Joanna rings like a shout in the night, and wouldn't you love to love her? Alright. Half the audience is like, what? What the hell is he saying? And by half, I mean like five people. But to you, well, 10 people, I guess. I'm impressed you've made it this far. We're pretty damn far into this Let's Play. Holy cow. This has got to be part like 160-ish, something like that. In damn sane. Alright, well, the exit was a lot easier than I thought it was going to be. See, I like fighting stuff like the trolls and stuff. They're fun to do. Whoa. Wait, is there a signpost here? Or is it down? Oh. Duh, is there a signpost there? I like fighting the big guys like that. I find that pretty fun to do. Alright, where is he? There's Crow's Perch. Crow's Perch. We'll probably be doing this quest here soon too, by the way. Alive and the victim of a curse was the key to finding the young woman. Doing some of the storyline stuff, because we are running kind of low on side quests. Oh, actually, you know what? No, what we're going to do next is Ursine armor. I really want to get that stuff made, because we can make their base armor, and we can make Or we can make and wear the base, and we can make and wear the enhanced. So, we might try another build here shortly. We'll see. I'm really liking this build, though, to be honest. Part of it is because... I mean, one, it's fun, because the signs come up so fast, and it's fun to just kind of mix and match the signs. Like, okay, you know, throw a Quinn on real quick to start the fight. It's like, okay, well, now you'll Yurden to get them going really slow. Or Axie, if it's just one guy. If you Axie them, it's really good, because then you can, okay, throw a Yurden down, wait for a 3-splenish, throw a Yurden trap down, and then by the time you've done all that, they're just now breaking out, in most cases, and now you can throw down an Igni to catch them on fire and to lower their armor. So it's a lot, it feels a lot more dynamic than otherwise.
How may I assist you?
Went to Undvik a while ago, found these.
Like 10 minutes ago.
Well, goose kicked me. These look like the real thing.
Because they are. Look at the markings. Authentic. How did you get them?
Wasn't easy, so I'm hoping for a good price on that armor of mine.
Harman Ep Grönikan, Lieutenant General of the 2nd Mounted Army. Welcome to our humble establishment. A true honor to host one of such renown. I've heard the General's a connoisseur and collector of armor. This is true, and they call you a master of the craft. All too kind, sir, truly.
I need a suit of armor, heavy, able to withstand piercing projectiles.
Piercing projectiles? Oh, bolts, you mean? That ain't easy. Needs a special alloy, tempering.
The new tools. We can do it. Stoke the fire. I'll ready the rest.
Bold, your worker. You allow her much.
You know how it is, General. Good help's hard to come by. We should go outside. There's business to discuss.
You're outside now. You can't go more outside.
It's always the same. I've had enough.
Enough?
They treat me like I'm nobody. The menial labor. Truth is, the Nilfgaardian, the one Fergus is kissing up to, I'll have to craft his armor. Yours too, for that matter.
So what's Fergus do?
Horseshoes, nails, not much else he can do, seeing as he cocks up simple bungs. But in the end, they call him Master. No one'd ever think I could be a skilled armorer, a human and a woman to boot. A dwarven blacksmith, oh, that's another story.
Gotta admit, find your story hard to believe myself.
I'll prove it to you. Fergus can make the Nilfgaardian's armor himself. I'll craft another suit. We'll see whose is better. I need but one thing I can't get on my own. Would you help me?
Depends what it is.
To finish the armor, I'll need to harden it, quench it in a bath. Oil's what we usually use, but I want to use acid.
Kiki Moors and Archgriffins spit acid.
Archgriffins? Draconic Griffins, you mean? Baron's men came by a few days back, said they'd seen one north of Crow's Perch. It had killed some folk out there.
Bound to be a notice posted for the Griffin anyway. Could kill two beasts with one stone. Fine, I'll see what I can do.
Bring me the acid and I'll prove I'm better than Fergus. And I'll craft armor for you, lots of it. The kind no other armorer can.
Hey. Alright, let's go get that. Oh, speaking of, hey, what do you know? There happens to be a message board update here. Thatch repair. I've got the knack and fix kit for fixing roofs. Any man neglecting the care for his own hut's a fool. A couple such sots and midcops refuse my services. Their huts burned to ash. I don't really see how those two things are related. Must have been fate sending fire to say it ain't kind to skimp on such things. So think it over, kind folk. Yeah, I feel like we got a little bit of a racket here. flogging. As punishment for failure to perform feudal duties, 100 lashes each have been administered to George of Shrain, Sten Brotus, Brotus the Elder, and Mussy Holland. May they serve as a reminder, the hand that feeds can also strike its wayward wards. Soothsayer, honest and true-sighted, I've many a year behind me and have been through much in each. In return, the gods have granted me the gift of sight. I need but take a hand and a gaze upon it before my eyes come to vision of what awaits the hand and its owner and all it touches. Some call it witchcraft and unnatural, this gift, but to my reckoning, it's the same as how some swim strong or play fiddle masterfully, while others sputter and screech. If you don't fear knowing what fate has in store, come pay a visit to Old Rack. We've a new batch of pups, 5 of them in all, small and spindly, but enough to make a stew of. I'll sell them for a few crowns each or exchange for other food. Yikes, it's getting a little rough around here. My daughter's hands be strong and supple, and more than one man or wife complaining of witch shot or other aches of the back have come to her greatly troubled and left at ease. If hard work in the fields has got you hunched over like a overburdened ox, come to our hut and find relief. P.S. Waste not your time nor ours with lecherous proposals. Griffin in the Highlands, what a surprise. Read close if you want to earn good coin and help your fellow men. In the hills north of Crow's Perch, there's some sort of beast lurking about, a griffin it would seem. If you kill it, bring the trophy to the quartermaster of Crow's Perch and you'll get a fitting reward. If you don't give a whit about your fellow men and don't have the bullocks to face a griffin, stay far away from that place or else you'll end up as the beast's dinner. Which I suppose means if you're feeling suicidal, you can go right ahead, waltz up to the monster and end your sorry life. Was that last paragraph really necessary?
Say no more.
All right, let's go find this thing that coincidentally just happened to show up right as we needed to. God damn it. Roach!
Go, go.
Why must you always vex me? All right, so again, we'll try to not use signs or anything. It's just a griffin, right? What level is this quest? It's probably about the same, I'd imagine. Yeah, 24. Griffin without bombs or anything shouldn't be too bad. Probably can signpost our way over there. Yeah, seems like it's gonna be a bit quicker. And it's right off the road too, it looks. I whistled him out of existence, apparently. Yeah, even with load times, that was saving me a little bit of time there if I don't get lost in this village, which is what I'm doing right off the bat. Oh, this is where the wild hunt came through. Yeah, I think that place is probably not going to be worth a hell of a lot for a while. Yeah, you know what? Let's just leave. Again, I don't know if it counts like attacking other things while you're on the quest. Again, I would not think so. No, stop. I mean, you're level 7, so I could just kill him with a sword if need be. They've mostly forgot me at this point. Nope. Nope. Geralt. Really? Geralt. Son of a bitch. Get out of here. Pricks. Put me into combat. Oh shit, hey. What's up? We're not done. Hey. Damn it. How are they, like, just hitting through that? Like, apparently when they're on a horse, they have, like, infinite stability. Now back to work. Oh, the griffin.
Seems mom didn't teach this little griffin not to play with its food.
Alright. This way. Excuse me, horses.
Arch griffin feather. Must have lost it when taking off. Hopefully its nest is nearby.
Gonna guess at the top of this hill. Just a wild guess. Yep, they're sheepalos. Come on down, big guy. Come on, don't be a little bitch. He's coming in for a land. Here we go, Jesus. I feel like you really fucking overplayed that shit. Eh. Alright, so they have that block where if you get hit, it like, stuns you, and then they get a free hit. So you can't even dodge out of the way of that one. If we can get the dots to actually land, then that'll help a lot. But these, it's not too difficult to get behind them. It's just getting their asses to stay on the goddamn ground is gonna be the annoying part. I keep saying, I'm gonna stop trying to do that, but then I find some circumstance to try to do it. If we don't beat him this time, we'll just beat his ass the normal way. Come on, you little prick. Just land! You don't need to circle around 20 fucking times. Shit. Eh. Gonna try to hit it from below. Bet. Wait, what? He can hit me from up there? Oh, that's some horse shit. Rock. Oop, easy. Alright, come on. Trying to stay behind his ass. For multiple reasons, obviously. That rock area is such a pain in the ass. Because he keeps getting stuck behind it. I can't get around him to smack him. But yeah, that's the worst part about that area, is that stupid little rock area that you fall underneath so that you can't hit him, but he can hit you. Just swing your sword higher, Geralt. Swing it that goofy method you used to do in the first game. My god, why is this loading so long? That's the other reason I just want to, like, say fuck it and just use signs, because I'm tired of waiting on the goddamn load times. Come on, let me get the inventory. There you go. Nope. Come on, prick. You wanna land sometime today? Thank you. Get away from these goddamn rocks. Spin on a goddamn dime. What? Is that an attack? Alright. We're gonna kill him normal. I don't have the patience to sit there and, like, jab and weave for the next 10 minutes as I slowly drain his health. We gave him a good shot, but it would just take way, 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 way too long. And again, this load time is atrociously bad right here for some bizarre reason. So I don't want it taking 45 seconds between attempts. Well, more like 20 to 30, but it feels like a goddamn minute. Oh lord, come on. That's probably the worst loading area we've ran into. That's consistently bad. Alright, nope, Quinn, thank you. There you go. Where are you at? Prick. Have some Dimitrium bomb, bitch. Stop running away, you little shit. Hey. Jesus fucking Christ. Fucking two shot. We're gonna have to heal up all the way because he's doing a fuck ton of damage. He does not like Axie. I think he might have been running away too, because I think maybe he was, even though he flies over that area, I'm wondering if his, like, he's not supposed to land and fight that far, so he was like freaking out trying to run back. And maybe that Dimitrium bomb might keep him from flying. That would seem weird, since that's not really a magical ability, but I'm definitely going to use it again, though. Alright, heal up. Axe his ass up here. Nope. Oh, what? Taking my stamina didn't work. Not what I did. Come on. Also not what I did. Yeah, Yurden has no effect at all. Nope, get out of that. I don't think that affects us. Yeah, he can't fly, I'm pretty well. Whoa. Alright, so now he's sort of slowed. Holy shit! That fire's doing insane damage. God damn! That fire did ridiculous damage! Arch Griffid, Acid Gland, and Trophy. Yes. it's funny, just like the vast difference in damage. Which, that's kind of wish this game allowed you to, like, have, like, when in some MMOs, they have like talent stables. Basically, what that means is, so right now, obviously, I'm built for medium armor and signs, but like I could have another build that was light armor and melee damage, and I could kind of switch between, like maybe not in the middle of a fight, but like between fights, maybe I had to meditate or something to switch. Instead of having to pay like 1,000 per potion, that's not a big deal. I think the thing is, like, well, it adds replay value, but this game's so insanely long that replay value's not really a big deal, because the game, it just takes, like, you're so much in one playthrough, it's absurd. Obviously, replay value on top of that is, you know, never a bad thing, but I feel like there's not going to be a ton of people out there who are like, I'm curious how many people actually utilize, for example, the New Game Plus. Like, again, I totally love that they have that. I think it's awesome that they have that as an option. But I wonder how many people do it, because like I say, the game is so damn long. And I realize, like, not everybody is going to do every bounty, every quest, every question mark, and all that. But I don't know. But, like, I mean, the cool thing, though, is, like, you know, if you have a very limited game budget, like, yeah, it's a $60 game, but holy hell, like, you absolutely get your money's worth. Let's go ahead and turn this in, I guess. I was going to go do that one first, but
how may I assist you?
Ah, whoops.
So long.
You talked to her.
You're back. So, got the acid?
No, oh, yeah, man.
Use it carefully. It's about as caustic as things come.
I know. It's burned many a man where I come from.
And where would that be?
Armor's ready. Now for the last touch. We'll soon see who's better, Fergus or me.
You definitely make armor much faster.
Geralt, it's done.
Ooh, nice.
Looks very professional.
Welcome, General. Armor's all ready. Came out splendid, if I do say so myself.
rather coarse. I trust the appearance does not reflect the quality.
General, I've also made a suit, if you please.
What is the meaning of this?
Exactly what it looks like. Joanna crafted a suit of armor for you, General, to prove she's the superior armorer.
For God's sake, Joanna! What do you think you're doing?
Temeria remains a wild land, it seems. Insubordination of this kind is not something we Nilfgaardians allow.
If I may, General, I am Fergus's subordinate in appearance alone. It's what we agreed, as few would ever believe a woman to be a better armorer than a dwarf.
You are right. I, for one, do not think it possible. But you are confident in your abilities. Let us put them to the test. Not on dummies, in live combat.
Oh, quite a crowd.
You there, put on this armor.
I'm just here to show me yours.
Mine is not a request.
General, I crafted this armor for a man. It can't fit me properly.
Then find another to wear it.
Geralt, will you help?
I want to know more about the test.
I ordered armor that would stop bolts. How do you think I intend to test it?
Geralt, you've nothing to worry about. This armor will easily withstand a bolt. Acid hardened. They need a ballista to pierce it. Help me, please.
Fine. Hope I won't regret this.
Don your armor, both. I will await outside.
Even if you get pierced by the bolt, we've got some soggy bread that you can eat. You'll be fine. The nipples are a little high and to the right, though, ma'am. I don't know if you've seen a...
I just came here to show me yours.
I can't move at all, okay.
Does this look to you like armor that stops bolts? Compensate the man. Now, let us see what this other suit is worth.
Hope you've got a really good aim, sir. Nice. Reflect it back at him.
But this armor's rubbish.
Stand. I wish to see the armor.
Rubbish.
Not even a dent.
I am not easily impressed. But I must admit, you have succeeded, my dear. Where to, dwarf? You must hear this. The forge is now Miss Joanna's. She will also assume all Nilfgaardian army requisitions. Is that clear?
Aye, as day.
Your pay for the armor. I will send a man to collect it.
I'll be going too, methinks. Just get my things.
Wait. We needn't part ways, Fergus. You've been a good helper. We could go on that way. But without the lie.
We did make quite the pair.
Well then, go stoke the fire. We've got a customer. He needs armor fit for a witcher. You weren't certain the armor would protect you. Admit it.
Correct.
Had a moment of doubt when the bolt pierced Fergus's armor. Didn't last long, though.
Thank you for trusting me. Give us a few days, and your armor will be ready.
Try 5 minutes!
Come on, let me help you get out of that.
Oh yeah! Easy, ma'am. Oh. Wait 1 day. See, only 1 day. Okay, cool. I probably will wait a day as well. Maybe. We'll see. Yeah, I probably will. Just see what it is. We'll probably do the Ursine quest first. So let's go finish this one quest up real quick. Oh god, please stop coming up with that. There we go. Turn in this griffin head. and we'll be done for this video. Which himself might take a while. I can't figure out. Wow, God, I'm on fire. Just like I intended.
Darkness everywhere. I see it all around.
What do you want, mate?
What?
You fake.
What is it, Grey Boy?
Grey Boy? Is that supposed to be an insult or?
Fancy a gander.
Heard you had a griffin problem.
Had.
Aye. Killed some villagers north of Crow's Perch. Folk came complaining to the Baron. He finally wearied of all the lamenting, offered a reward for the beast's head.
Good thing, too. I could use some crowns.
Well, folks say all kinds of shite about you lot. But gotta give a witcher his due. Here, fair pay for a fair day's work.
All right, what was a fair day's pay? Yeah, get the good stuff. 25 crowns! Come on! I killed a griffin! Level 24 griffin! And tracker's trousers? I mean, alright. But, whatevs. Anyway. So, that's it for today. Thanks again to Asger for continued support on Patreon. Make sure you guys leave comments in the comment section below. Follow me on Twitter, and I will see you next time.